Life's no living up, watching time go. Planning moves, staying solid to this cheat code. Get your money, make it big, fuck being broke. Get your money, make it big, fuck being broke. Live slow, live it up, watching time go. Making moves, staying solid to this cheat code. Get your money, make it big, fuck being broke. Get your money, make it big, fuck being broke. This how it is, the mission's Benjamin's. And fuck the drama and the bullshit, we ain't little kids. My circle's small, but my writer's heart, they never quit. Get your money, keep it dancing, solid street legit. Never switch, like the real ones that die for this. It's fucked up, but this is truly how it is. I hope you're ready if you're picking this like full of sin. No turning back, I'll represent my vital to the end. Fuck the fakes and the snakes and everyone that hates. I'm not fazed, I won't break, bitch, I'll never
change. You are now watching MOD Entertainment.
What's good, G-Life? This right here is LA County, my home. And we'll be heading towards the section that is known as NELA. NELA being Northeast Los Angeles, where it's home to one of, you know, NELA's oldest barrios within this area, close to the Los Angeles riverbed, which it is known as the FTR neighborhood. FTR, translating to fuck the rest, is a phrase that they use, but the barrio is actually known as Frogtown Rifa. Frogtown Rifa is already an old barrio that has already been right here since the 1920s, 1930s, when this neighborhood was established. And the barrio's name, Frogtown, isn't only the name that the gang refers to this area, but that's actually what the community called this area. The community called this area due to the fact that there used to be a bunch of frogs within this area because of the vegetation that grows right there alongside the Los Angeles River. You get a lot of frogs, especially when it rains a lot. You get a bunch of frogs, you know, all throughout the whole entire Elysian Valley. That is why this area is referred to as Frog Town. That is how they get their name. And this barrio is located right here, you know, close to Riverside Drive, where the Golden Freeway's at and the Glendale Freeway meet up right there on and a Arroyo Seco Parkway all meet up. You know, that's why you get the way it looks, you know, with all the freeways, and you get all the homeless encampments underneath all of that, because, you know, it makes a perfect spot, you know, for these individuals to take shelter and etc. But with that, you know, it's going to come with a lot of crime and a lot of illegal activity within the area. That is just how it goes, you know, throughout this parkway, the bike path and all of that. Even though the area has gone through gentrification, don't ever get it twisted. This area is still very notorious and very dangerous, and like at one point it was really hectic right here, you know what I mean? You couldn't just walk through these parks at night, especially because the area, how the Elysian Valley is designed, is that all of these areas were dead ends, cul-de-sacs, because the freeway's right there, so they were cul-de-sacs, so they were dead ends, so you went turning the wrong street, I mean, you probably weren't, you know, gonna come out alive, you know what I'm saying? It was very notorious and very rooted how it was. And this barrio is also a barrio that is well known because of the Mexican actor Emilio Rivera, Lefty, who actually plays the character in A Man Apart, Friday After Next, and Anarchy. He is the baby Joker that everybody refers to in Friday After Next. That is who he is. This is his barrio. This is the barrio that he's from. He is from the barrio Frogtown Rifa. You know, one of Nela's oldest barrio. It is large and still continues to be active till this day. You know, it has even said to, you know, that several other gangs within the area sprouted off of the Frogtown Rifa gang. So, you know, these guys have their reputation and they're very notorious within this area. The Frogtown gang does not play. And like I said, that is the reason why they're named Frogtown, because of the rain and the vegetation, and they get a lot of frogs within the area. That is even how the, you know, citizens that live in this area refer to this area as Frogtown. So it's not just the gang that calls themselves like that, but the actual area. And the Frogtown Rifa neighborhood still continues to be there on, like I said, on Riverside Drive, because they do have different sides, like the church side, the park sides, and like that, that they split their turf in divisions like that. You know, you have several clicas, you know, that roam and patrol their areas. Like I said, it's very notorious, well-structured, and continue to still represent theirs and hold it down for that barrio Frogtown Rifa. Hey, these guys ain't playing, homie. They with the business, and they continue to still hold it down for theirs and putting theirs on the map. Now, as we make our way to the city of Torrance in the harbor area, the city of Torrance is another area where we're able to find another frog neighborhood within this neighborhood that often gets forgotten. I don't hear that many people ever bring up this barrio, and it is a real barrio. Not only is it a real barrio, it is one of harbor area's most oldest barrio. Not only is it harbor area's most, one of harbor area's most oldest barrios, but it is one of the oldest, if not the oldest barrio in the city of Torrance. Even though you do have other gangs like Eastside Torrance and 204th Street and stuff like that, there is a barrio that came before all of those barrios and that hardly gets brought up, which is Barrio LR, Barrio La Rana. Barrio La Rana is an old school neighborhood that has been right here in this area since the 1930s when this neighborhood was established. That's what I was told. So it being one of Torrance's oldest barrios and the harbor area itself, you know what I mean? This is an old barrio that was located right here in the area that is referred to as El Pueblo, the town of Del Amo. Del Amo is a boulevard that stretches through their barrio. It was the area where you're able to find a lot of the oil refineries and a lot of jobs, you know, within the time. But the area was very chaotic. It had a lot of drug sales. It had a lot of murders and it had a lot of prostitution. Hence why most of the pueblito that was right there got demolished. It is now where the Torrance Mall is located at, the Del Amo Mall, one of, you know, the largest malls, you know what I mean? That is the reason why they bulldozed the area down and everything, because they didn't see, even though the neighborhood and the citizens try to fight to keep their homes and stuff like that, the city scene, you know, didn't see it beneficial because of the crime rate and all of that. So now whatever's left of their barrio is just a small portion of Del Amo, but before it was a lot more larger. Before the mall was there, you already know how it goes with gentrification and stuff like that. They don't really care about, you know, families losing their homes and etc. Because their barrio was everything from Del Amo Boulevard, right there where Pueblo's at on Crenshaw and Van Ness. So everything that's in the middle was their barrio, you know, the area that was referred to as La Rana. Now, the reason why their name was La Rana the Frog, because that's what that translates into, is because there used to be a little pond right there. And in that pond, there used to be a bunch of frogs. And that is how they got their name, La Rana, because of all the frogs within that area, because of the pond. So that is how they got their name, and they have no connection to the rest of the, you know, the frog gangs. They all have their own stories and how they came up and stuff like that. And this is theirs, you know. The area was very notorious. One of Torrance's, not only Torrance, but one of Harbor Area's most notorious areas. It was known for its drug sales and prostitution. So you used to get a lot of, you know, individuals that were up to no good within the area. And you used to get a lot of, you know, shootings and murders and et cetera, stuff like that. It used to crack before. People see Torrance now and being like, nah, it's nice and stuff like that. But what people have to realize is how the area is now is not how the area has always been. You know what I mean? What the area was then and what the area is now is two different things. So that's why while people may look at it now and say like, oh, this is a nice area, how could gangs possibly exist right here, people have to keep it in mind that that's not how the area has always been, because right here before it was very chaotic. But the Rana neighborhood still continues to be up and representing theirs, you know, one of Harbor Area's most oldest gang, and they consider to still strive because they still have members holding it down for theirs and putting theirs on the map for the LR gang. And now as we make our way down to the area of LA County that is known as the Southeast area is the area that's within Norwalk, Whittier, Artesia, and around those areas to the area that is called Santa Fe. Most people know of Santa Fe due to the Santa Fe Swap Meet, the open swap meet. It's very, you know, popular place. Really good stuff too. I recommend going there. It's one of my favorite places that I like going to. But the area within Santa Fe is where you're able to find another one of these, old, frog neighborhoods. Because if there's one thing that all the frog neighborhoods have in common is that they're very old school barrios, due to the fact of how they got their name as well. You know what I mean? Because nowadays when people see it, you rarely see frogs within these areas, but back then they used to be all over the place, especially when it would rain, and it was no different right here in Santa Fe Springs. Santa Fe used to get a lot of frogs, and it is why this barrio gave themselves the name as Barrio Cantarrana Viejo. Barrio Cantarrana Viejo is an old neighborhood in the southeast, one of southeast's oldest barrios. It has been around since the 1930s that I was told that this barrio has been right here established. And it is a very large, notorious neighborhood. As a matter of fact, I had said this in the last time that I had covered Cantarrana's, FBI, ranks them, one of, a very dangerous neighborhood. And that's coming out of FBI, homie. So you already know, homie, when they saying that they dangerous, my boy, then they dangerous and notorious. The Barrio Cantarrana translates to the singing frog, because, in the night you would be able to hear all the frogs' mating calls and stuff like that. So, it sounds like they singing. So that is why they gave their barrio's name, Cantarrana, because it was the area that was known for the singing frogs, where you would be able to hear the songs, the frogs singing. And their territory is everything, within Santa Fe, Santa Fe area, close to the Santa Fe High School, is where their barrio's at, all the way to Los Nietos Park. So from the Santa Fe High School to Los Nietos Park and everything that's in the middle, which is a, pretty massive amount of territory, is their barrio. You know what I mean? Obviously, the Cantarrana neighborhood is not only located here, but it has a different location as well. But this is its original location right here on Pioneer Boulevard and Orenday Road. Is where you're able to find this barrio, right there close to the Jersey Avenue Elementary School, is where the Cantarrana, holds it down. You know what I mean? And not only there, but they also have a different chapter, located, if you head a little bit more down, to the area that's closer to Whittier, on Norwalk Boulevard to, Mines Boulevard and Washington Boulevard. So everything that's in the middle of Washington and Mines is their barrio. And from the opposite ends, you know what I mean? To where the freeway's at, is where, throughout Norwalk Boulevard is where you're able to find the other portion of the Cantarrana, neighborhood. And not only here located, within the southeast, but I was also told that they're located up in Northern Cali, and they're also located, within Riverside. At least that's what I was told. So they do have several branches in different locations, but these are their main headquarters. You know what I mean? The main spots, their domain, their dojos. And they do have several clicas, from the Viejos to the Seekers, and all of that, So they do have clicas to their barrios. The Viejos obviously being the original clique, the old ones, the main ones, the ones that came when it first started. That's why you do see it up as CR or CRV. Either one, is right. Cantarrana or Cantarrana Viejo. That's what the V stands for. Because I heard someone say that it's Cantarrana Barrio 13, but that's not what it is. It's Cantarrana Viejo. And then it's just the 1-3. And this barrio, like I said, has been around already since the 30s, up to more than 500 members to the Cantarrana neighborhood. So we're talking about a large neighborhood within this area. You know what I mean? And right here, it gets chaotic because you do have so many barrios within this area. You have Rivera, you have Pico Nuevo, you have the Jimstown, you have the Vicky's Town, you have Los Nietos. You have so many different barrios, so it gets chaotic right here within this area. Not only that, you do have some Crip sets as well. So it does get hectic within this area, but the Cantarrana neighborhood has been established there, and continues to be established there, and it seems like there's no slowing down, even though, they already hit them with all kinds of sweeps. They made headlines, all kinds of shit, but yet this barrio still continues to represent for theirs and put theirs on the map for the Barrio Cantarrana, the CRV.
Thank you for watching MOD Entertainment.